Hello and welcome to the episode 68 of What A Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, among other things, we will have the start of a new package tour, the end of some shooting sessions, and a recording session in Abbey Road. This is one of those episodes for which I am recording a bit of extra material, and that will be available in the future for those supporting the podcast. Please keep an eye on www.simonmas.com/support to find out more on this and other ways in which you can be fab and support the creation of my music-related content. Thank you! On the 9th of March 1962, the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, performed a lunchtime and an evening concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool. The evening performance was the 150th concert at that venue. In 1963, only 5 days after the end of the Helen Shapiro National Package Tour, the Beatles embarked in another such endeavor, this time third in a three-act bill topped by Tommy Roe and Chris Montez. They were established musicians, Americans, which at the time in UK was a guarantee for rock and roll authenticity, both having some hits under their belt. Chris Montez had Let's Dance and Tommy Roe had Sheila. It only took this night's concert at the Granada Cinema in London to flip the order, showing what the public really wanted and having the Beatles heading the bill in all the other dates of the tour. The repertoire of the band for the various concerts comprised of Love Me Do, Misery, A Taste of Honey, Do You Want to Know a Secret, Please Please Me, and I Saw Her Standing There. Moving on to 1964, we find the Beatles completing the filming of the train scenes for A Hard Day's Night, travelling from London to Newton Abbot in Devonshire. It had taken them some 2,500 miles, about 4,023 kilometers, of travelling back and forth from London to conclude all the sequences on the train. And actually, it wasn't enough, considering that the band shot their performance of I Should Have Known Better taking place on a train at the Twickenham Studios, as we will see in episode 70 of What A Fab Day. More shooting in 1965, with a final day of filming in the Bahamas for the Fab Four involving some pickup shots on Paradise Island. A pickup shot is a relatively minor shot intended to augment some already shot footage or to correct small details in it. Finally, in 1967, the Beatles busied themselves at the Abbey Road EMI Studios between 7 p.m. and 3:30 a.m. The aim of the recording session was to record the rhythm track of Getting Better, a goal achieved after 7 takes. For the occasion, Paul McCartney played electric guitar. The tape, comprised of Paul's electric guitar and Ringo Starr's drums on track 1, Paul's guide vocals on track 2, George Martin's pianette and electric keyboard on track 3, and more drums by Ringo on track 4. The work proceeded with a gradual reduction of take 7 into take 12 to achieve the best result. Take 12 didn't feature any vocals and had enough free space for further overdubs. The session was one of the few in which the usual engineer and tape operator of the Beatles, Jeff Emerick and Richard Lush, were given a night off by EMI. Substitute Malcolm Addy, who had worked extensively with Cliff Richard and the Shadows, remembers in Mark Lewison's The Complete Beatles Recording Sessions. I remember the session was booked to begin at 7 p.m, but there was barely a Beatle in sight much before midnight, and we were sitting around waiting. They eventually struggled in one by one. Ringo came in about 11 and ordered fish and chips. The others arrived later. They all hung around and finally started to work at about 1 in the morning. The ego trip of the big-time artists had started to set in. I know their method of working upset Jeff from time to time. In my personal opinion, this work attitude and the hanging around in studio altogether would also add some weight to the problems that will end up breaking up the Beatles. This concludes this episode of What A Fab Day. Tomorrow we will talk about the lads dropping their first manager. And no, it's not Brian Epstein. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.